Hello beauties, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Fit Dominic. Okay, so in today's video we're gonna try a simple beginner makeup look. Alright, so in my previous video I showed you the products and where you can get it, and I also show you the price of the product. So in this video we're gonna use all the products that I showed you earlier on. So for the face swipe, I use it to cleanse my face. Now I'm priming using the Sharpen primer. I've already showed you the price and how you can, now I'm showing you the process how you can use them. So I'm just applying the products in my face right now. So after that I'm going to rub it in to just blend into my skin to moisturize and also serve as a primer. It also dry sweat, so it's very good. It's good for beginners and really affordable. Alright, so after that leave it for a bit, like 5 seconds, before applying something else. Then I'll be going to my foundation right now, which is the Maybelline foundation, the shade 355. Sorry about that. So I'm just applying it to my foundation brush. This brush came with that set of brushes I showed you in that video. Okay, so if you have not watched that video, just go ahead and watch it right now because you will understand it more. I just showed you everything that you need in makeup. Now I'm just using the brush to apply the foundation into my face. You must not use your BB sponge. Okay, I feel that the BB sponge just suck out the product. Understand? You have to waste the product in a way. So instead of that, I use my foundation brush to apply it into my face. And please avoid your hairline, okay? Don't push foundation to your hairline because it's gonna show different colors, okay? That just simply is, I'm showing the circle, your hairline, your undershake, okay? So avoid applying foundation there. Maybe when you are moving to your beauty sponge, it will also go there. But when you put it in your hairline, it will move to your wig or your hair that you are making already. So I'm showing the two sets of brushes. Two brush look similar, but one is like a foundation brush. Understand? That one is stronger than the other one. So I'm just using it to just puff in the foundation more into my face, and this will help the foundation to blend in more. Okay, don't skip this step. Okay, people on YouTube do not show you this process, but they always do this. I don't know if you understand. If you want your makeup to stay for long and you want that flawless look, first of all, use this brush before moving to your beauty sponge. So this beauty sponge that I'm using right now to just type in the product. This will help me to press the foundation inside. I don't know if you understand. I'm just pressing it inside. The other one I was swiping, now I'm pressing it inside because I have already blended to my face. Okay, so for the hairline now, you can just blend it right now so that you will not be having foundation will not be showing your hairline. All right, so that is what I'm doing right now. I'm just tapping in the foundation, tap, just like that. I'll just be tapping it in. So for concealer, I've already showed you this concealer, the Usha concealer, and this brush also come with that set of brush that I showed you in that video. Understand? So I'm using that shade. Like I said, that shade is my shade. That is the only shade I can use in this palette, and I noticed that it at least goes a long way in this concealer. Please, you don't need too much concealer on your face. Understand? This little that I apply on my face is too much. You will see that I use this part, only this concealer, to align my full face. Just imagine, I use this, the concealer that I apply in that part, to apply my full face. No, I wish I did not use it like that. I just started blending. I will not be able to blend the concealer out. So just apply little by little. Understand? So even if when you pack it from that palette, so warm it up on your palms a bit before applying it, because it will help you just pack the product direct to your face, which is not good. And if you're not careful, you bring creases and you will not even like how the foundation will turn out to be. Understand? So I'm just being careful, then using it to just, instead of cleaning it out, I'm just being careful then using it to apply in the rest part of my face. But on a normal day, don't go and pack foundation under your eyeliner, using concealer under your eyeliner that you use to feel everywhere. No, please don't do that. Okay, it's very wrong. Understand? So contour, like I said, I don't have my dark shade over there, so I'm going to use the SDK foundation to contour this shade Cocoa, and I'm moving to that flat brush. And so I'm just warming it up on my pants a bit. Okay, so this is how you warm your foundation up, and then using it to contour my face. All right. So after that, I'm going to blend the foundation in the concealer out right now. So I'm using the other side of my BC sponge, okay? Not the part that I apply the foundation on. Understand, the part that I used to blend the foundation, sorry about that. The part that I used to blend the foundation, I will not use that side to blend my concealer, because you just move the concealer, it will change the color you are seeing there right now. So instead of that, okay, you understand what I did over there, right? I changed the beauty sponge. I noticed that the concealer was too much, so you wanted to push more than and expected it. So instead of that, I changed it to that other side. I used to apply my foundation to just blend it concealer more, so that it will be seamless. I return to just blend it out. So take your time to just blend. I have a detailed video on how to highlight and contour. I'm gonna link it up there, so you can just go ahead and watch it, okay? So this will just help. This is how I blend the contour and the fan and the highlighter, the concealer that I used to highlight and my contour out with my foundation. So you know there are three shades over there already. So I'm gonna set my face right now using the Sasha Buttercup, the darker one, not that light one, okay? So I'm using my beauty sponge to just type in the powder just like that. I'm setting, I'm not baking, so you don't need much, just little. Understand? Just press it in as if you want the wet, am I gonna put it, the foundation to be dried. Understand? So just like that, just setting, not baking. I'm not packing the powder in. I'm just pressing it into my face, okay? So that is it. So to contour my nose, I'm beginning to that powder palette and that shade I just showed you. That is what I'm using to contour my nose. And if you really watch that video, you know the palette I'm talking about, and it's really affordable too. Okay, so I'm just using it to contour my nose. So I didn't use any other products, any other thing in this video. I'm just showing you everything that I showed you in that video and how you can use them, alright? So there's nothing special, no more thing that I apply on this video that I've not shown you before. So I'm trying to tell you that you can actually do full face makeup using this product, okay? So I'm gonna use those two shades right now, okay? So I'm moving on to that big brush that I showed you earlier on. Understand? So this is the essence of the big brush. It will help me to just blend everything into my face very well. So when mixing a powder like that, you press the two together and then dust out the excess product, then press it to your face well. So I'm moving to brow right now. I did show you this brush, okay? So you can get this brush separately, about 100 naira, but do come with some set of brush, but not come with yours, no problem about that. So I'm using the David Brow pencil right now. I use the shade to draw the line. Understand? I don't want to go more detail about brows, because I've been doing brow tutorial on most all my videos, and I still have brow tutorial on this my channel. So I don't want to waste your time, waste the MB doing repeating one thing at a time, every time, okay? So I want this. So this shade 18 is what I use to fill in the brows. Understand? So that is the essence of the two shade, and I have a very detailed brush tutorial, just check it out please. And it's really detailed, I put it as a full video. Understand? So I'm fine, I'm just showing you what I use. Understand? I'm just filling it in using the shade 18. So I like the brows. I'm using that same Usha Concealer palette. That's the shade that I used to highlight my face. That is the only shade I can use in this powder palette, okay? But if you're darker than me, I'm sorry darling, because I have to mix it with that ZK foundation to be dark a bit. Or please don't even mix it, just get another concealer that have a darker shade. I know there are also some concealer that have more darker shade than this Usha concealer, but I did take my time to select. So this one that I got not have other skin. Understand? So after that, I'm just cleaning the brush. And so I'm moving to my foundation, which is the Maybelline foundation. Understand? To highlight the outer corner of my brows. You know, I love using it like this. If I just use the concealer alone, I would not love the way the brow will come out, because it will be too light for me, and I don't really love my brow like that. So I love using foundation and concealer to highlight my brows. Okay, so that's what I'm doing right now. For the top part, I'm using the foundation to highlight it more. So after that, now I'm using the leftover concealer in my hand to just prime my eyes before going to my eyeshadow. Listen, so just skip this step, always do it, always prime your eye before going to any other thing. You can even set it first before going to your eyeshadow. So I'm going to set it with using that powder palette, understand, using that shade to just set my eyes, all right, to just give you that flawless look. Even though you don't want to apply, how am I gonna put it, eyeshadow, doing this alone will make your eyes really so beautiful. Understand? If you really want the simple glam look, just go ahead, do it like this, draw your eyeline, so you're good to go. They will even think that you apply eyeshadow. Officially, you don't apply anything, and that is really simple glam look. Okay, so if your client needs a simple look, you can also do this to her, or I don't know, but I'm gonna create a look that you will do like this to be very simple. Just apply a little glitter, understand, or pigment, a little pigment, okay, to just spread it up a bit. So I'm doing the same to the other eye. So for baking, I'm using this Sacha Buttercup. This one is really light under the other one. That one was dark. So I'm just baking, okay, and I'm using my beauty sponge to just tap in the product into my face. Okay, so I need the mush. So I'm just baking, not too much. Understand? So for my eyeshadow, you can also, I'm changing this process, okay, so this is a lipstick. I'm just giving it a base to, for the eyeshadow to just set in, understand, to just make it to pump up more than just applying it natural. So that is it. So for eyeshadow, I'm using that Juvia's eyeshadow palette. I've already showed you the eyeshadow palette before, so you already know the price. So I'm moving on to another brush. Another brush come instead of 10, and you cannot even finish them. You cannot even use them in one, just doing one face, makeup in one face. No. So I'm just using one of the fluffy brushes to just pop in the eyeshadow. So nothing much, just wash and learn. I'm not gonna explain much on this, right? Okay, after that, I'll be going to that palette, that same Ushav concealer palette, and I'm using that shade over there as if I'm doing cut crease. Okay, I'm not doing cross crease, so I'm just trying to just, how am I gonna put this? I don't know how to explain this, but that is the shade I'm using right now. Understand? I'm just using it to pop in before going to the next shade. I'm not doing cut crease, I'm just priming it more, alright? Okay, after that, I'm doing my eyeliner right now. I'm just laying my eyes, understand? So next, I'm going to my David Bragg pencil to just line my lip. That color lip liner that I have is a yellow shade. No, not a yellow, it's orange, of which I don't like it. I can't really use that to line my lip, it was too much. So I need that kind of shade like this, or a brown shade. Then if you have any brown lip liner, you can also use that. Or you can use a MAC lip liner. That is very good, the MAC products, but I did show you that. So I'm just using all those lipstick that I showed you earlier on to apply my lip. Okay, so that was all. Just watch the rest of the video and I hope you like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. If you have not subscribed, just help me to grow. Okay, your subscription matters a lot. All right, just like, click the like button, subscribe if you have not subscribed. Okay, so watch the rest part of the video and okay, so bye.